Canada, and welcome to NHL Classics here on ESPN Classic. This time, the Wayback Machine takes us to October the 20th of 1979, and a game between Philadelphia and Detroit. And it was a historic game because it marked the final home opener for the Red Wings at the Olympia Stadium. Since 1927, Detroit's NHL franchises took up residency in the building they called the Old Red Barn. First it was the Cougars, then the Falcons, and since 1927, the Red Wings. This was the arena that saw the likes of Howe, Lindsay, Abel, Delvecchio, Sawchuk. But after some 50 years, it was now making way for the brand new Joe Louis Arena. The Joe would host its first NHL game in just a few months, December 27th. So this was the last home opener and one of the few home games remaining. 15,417 on hand, an Olympia opening game record. All right, let's go back. Turn the dial. October 20th, 1979. It's the Flyers. It's the Red Wings. The call, Larry Osterman and Mickey Redmond.
Jimmy Rutherford in goal for the Red Wings and Phil Meyer for the Flyers. And this game is underway. Draws one by the Flyers. Right out to center ice, intercepted there by Willie Hilbert. Shot into the left wing corner, chasing it in as Hogebaum bumped against the board. The puck comes free on the near side. Woods tries to dig it out. Clark is in the corner with him. Now dug up by the Wings. Bolduc tries to get a shot off, and it's deflected into the corner. Now along the far boards. Thrown in behind the net. Comes to the right side, out to the right. We played 40 seconds of the season's opener for the Red Wings. And the faceoff will be coming up to Jimmy Rutherford's left. Kenny Lindsman in to take the draw for the Philadelphia Flyers. And the big guy, Mahovlich, in for the Red Wings. Ball goes in behind the Red Wings net, picked up there by Perry Miller. Throws it to the near side. Puck in the corner. Dug out there by Larson. Throws it to the far wing. Now in behind his own net, it comes to Hogebaum. He shoots it up the ice, a little bit too far for Hicks to handle. And it's collected by the Flyers at center ice. Shot into the Red Wings end. Larson along the near corner. And tapped away by Rutherford. Along the near boards. Larson in the corner. And it's tapped away. A centering pass is deflected high off the stick. Bill Barber and goes into the seats.
That was a good play there, Larry, by Nedimansky, who came back from his wing position to cover the man in front of the net, or that could have been a 1-0 hockey game.
Now the teams change once again with the two coaches getting new personnel on early. Val Bridgman will take this face off with Mahovlich, whose line stays on. Huber is on, along with Tommy Bergman defensively for the Red Wings. Huber tries to throw it the far side, deflected into the corner by Bridgman. Bridgman skates in, a shot, bouncing around. It looked like it went in, but it's waved off by the referee. That puck hit the post, came back out, and Rutherford fell on it.
Oh, they got a break there, Larry. That puck went by Jimmy Rutherford, hit the goal post, and came out and laid right on the goal line. He grabbed it with his goalie glove, so we're lucky on that one.
So the faceoff will be to Rutherford's right. We're in the first period here at Olympia as Bridgman skates in for the faceoff with Mahovlich. Draw comes out to the left point. A shot by Watson is steered to the right. Picked up behind the net and thrown to the near side. Comes out to Mahovlich. Shoots ahead to center ice to Hicks. The left wing, a backhander by Huber. Turned into the left corner. Out to the left point, a shot by Hamel. Turned away by Meyer. Comes to the right boards, and out along the right boards to center ice, where it's picked up by Bridgman. Bridgman has it knocked off his stick. Get a whistle. We've got it offside against the Philadelphia Flyers. Face-off will be at the spot just above the Red Wings blue line. It'll be Dale McCourt taking the draw with Rick McLeish. Larson in his own end. Throws it to the far wing. Long shoots it up along the left wing boards. McCourt controls along the left boards and it's poke checked away. Taken there by Vervegaard. Out comes the center ice. A shot from the blue line sails off the glass. A wrist shot by McLeish. Larson in behind his own net. Now McCourt goes in along with Vervegaard. Finally dug out momentarily by Long. Now in behind the Red Wings net. Comes to the left side. A wrist shot stopped by Rutherford. He can't get to it. The cover it up. Gets away from Larson. Picked up now by Kelly. Kelly's centering pass turned away. Along the near board. And finally raked out by Foligno. But he loses the puck now to Vervegaard. Now comes out to center. Thrown back into the Red Wings end by McLeish. And offside is the call.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, lease an Accord or CRV from $298 a month. So get to the Honda Checkered Flag event fast.
Hi, this is Chuck Storm. I'm live at the scene where last night there was a robbery at about 3:30 in the morning. Now, police have...
Subway restaurants and discover how many ways there are to make your sandwich your way. Subway, think fresh, eat fresh.
The new JVC Avereo hard drive camcorder. Share your videos with one-touch upload to YouTube and easy export to your iTunes library. The all-new JVC Avereo hard drive camcorder.
The perfect experience. JVC.
Gotta tell you something.
Clark goes into the Red Wings end, taken by Bergman, throws it to the far side of Miller. Miller tries to get out to McCourt, knocked off his stick, bounces into the right corner. Now Bergman throws it to the left side, puts it right on the stick of Frank Bate. Now rolling in behind the Red Wings goal, it is thrown to the near side by Tommy Bergman. Now it comes out to McCourt. McCourt has it knocked off his stick. The Red Wings have trouble getting it out. Now they do. LeBrocken has it poked off his stick by Bob Daly. Now picked up by LeBrocken at center ice. Moves it off to the right to Foligno. Foligno has it knocked away. LeBrocken picks it up. LeBrocken with a centering pass, and it's turned away by Daly. Goes to the right and into the behind the net. Now thrown out to Miller at the left point. Winds up, lets it fly, and it's off the stick of Meyer. Comes to the right side. Bergman trying to keep it in, but can't get to the puck, and it comes all the way back to the Red Wing end. Taken by Perry Miller. He shoots it out to LeBrocken. Starts it up the left wing. LeBrocken flying as he approaches the Flyers' blue line, and has puck checked away there by Bailey. Comes out to center. Taken by Bergman. Bergman shoots it toward the Flyers' blue line. Picked up now by Barber, and offside is the call against the Flyers at the Red Wing blue line.
Well, both teams going end-to-end here, Larry, and it's a hot night in this building. We've got a full house, and I'm telling you, these guys will never keep that pace up all night.
It has been end-to-end competition thus far. The Flyers very dangerous on one occasion. Rutherford was up to it. We have no score. We've played 3 minutes 55 seconds of the first period. Face-off at center ice. Goes into the wing's right corner. Stopped by Rutherford. Throw back to the far side. Drop pass down to the right point. A shot from there by Watson is turned away and comes to the near. Now Sobchuk moves it on the left wing. Comes to center ice to Huber. And offside at the blue line, the Red Wings. The faceoff will be just above the Flyers' blue line on the near side. Sobchuk skating in for the draw with Kenny Linsman. Now Linsman is out of there, and Barber skates in for the draw. Goes into the Flyers' end and cleared out immediately. Kelly on the far side moves it to center ice. Picked up there by Barber. Barber shoots it down the right way, moving in, a shot off the stick of and a good save by Rutherford. Goes to the left corner. Polonich taps it to the far side. Chased there by Barber. And Thompson. The puck comes free. Picked up by Kelly. Kelly. Shot turned away. Goes in behind the net. Polonich gets it out now to Sobchuk. Out to center ice it comes. And it's dumped into the right wing corner by Earl Thompson. A shot by Polonich sails wide to the left. And all the way out to center ice. Terry Miller. He's got Woods ahead, but he didn't see him. And a pass goes to Polonich as he goes into the Flyers' zone. It's knocked away. Picked up there by Bosniak. Now at center ice, Larson. Loses the puck to Barnes. Larson back in his own end to Woods. Woods at center ice, pinned against the boards, and it's picked up by Barnes. Barnes to DuPont. Now the Red Wings, a puck chopped over the stick of Woods and goes on into the Philadelphia end. Good hard check to fight on the far side by Perry Miller. And the Red Wings bring it up the ice. Larson trying to stick the handle two between two men. And it's shot into the Flyers' end. Barnes clears it the length of the ice. And it's picked up by Larson in his own end. He overskates the puck. Picked up there by Kropp, a shot and he scores. Well, a mistake cost the Red Wings dearly there as Ryan Kropp picked up the loose puck and jabbed it home.
Well, a little overskating the puck, Larry, in our own zone. I think that's the same problem we talked about before the game. You just can't be too careful back in front of your own zone. And Reed Larson, and here's the young rookie Kropp, took it and fired it high over Jimmy Rutherford's left shoulder.
It's a 1-0 hockey game with the Philadelphia Flyers making the goal as it was picked up by Prop after being lost. And it's 1-0 the Flyers. Bridgman gets it out front, and it's still in play for the Flyers. A backhander by Holmgren sails to the corner. Now picked up by Holmgren. Holmgren centering pass. Knocked in behind the net by Bailey. Now Mahovlich escapes off and comes up the middle of the ice. Mahovlich chased the right wing. and loses the puck, and he turns it over now to Frank Faith. Hubert center ice. Offside to Thompson, drives it into the corner. Bailey pinned against the board, picked up by Mahalich, a shot and a stick save made by Myers as it sailed up against the glass and into the crowd.
In the war between fun and practicality, there are victims and there are victors. To the victor go the spoils. All new, all that, Mazda 3.
For 50 years, Harvey's introduces the gift burger. Buy any burger and on your next visit, get a free original burger.
Free? Wow.
It feels so good to give.
Harvey's makes your hamburger a beautiful thing.
Imagine.
Lotto 649's next jackpot is $15 million.
The Bears are what we thought they were. They're what we thought they were. We played them in preseason. Who the hell takes a third game in a preseason like a We played them in the third game. Everybody played three quarters. The Bears are who we thought they were. That's why we took the damn field. Now, if you want to crown them, then crown their ass. But they are who we thought they were. And we let them off the hook.
McCourt will be taking the faceoff with Bobby Clark just above the Red Wings blue line. Watson throws to the far side. Shot into the Red Wings end, comes along the near boards. Watson knocked off the puck, and it comes out down to McCourt. McCourt with a late pass to LeBrocq. LeBrocq moving in, and a good save by Meyer. The rebound, McCourt scores!
Example of LeBrat and his skating, Larry. He cut in there, made the defenseman make a move on him. The goaltender down, and Dale just picked up the loose puck off the goaltender's pads and slammed it into the open net. But I think LeBrat's speed in that case coming up the left side made that play possible.
Spin around the defenseman, the final wall before Meyer presence loomed in front of him. And he got a good hard shot on. The court was capped right there, and it was a quick goal for the Red Wings to tie it at 1-1. LeBrocq and Larson get the assist on the goal by McCourt. The time of the goal, 8:45 of the first period. The Flyers with a puck momentarily. Comes to center ice, raked away by Bergman. Bergman into the Flyer zone on left wing. Takes it to the corner, his centering pass, but nobody's there. And it comes out along the near boards. Picked up by Lensman. Lensman stopped at the blue line. Puck comes free, a shot sails wide off the stick of Bill Barber, turned away by Rutherford, and goes to the corner. Dug out by Barber, he's pinned against the boards by Tommy Bergman, and we'll have a face-off to the left of Jimmy Rutherford.
The Wings are going to be playing a little loose in their own end here, Larry, and I think that that's the reason Philadelphia is getting so many good chances. If it wasn't for Jimmy Rutherford, this game could be a 3-1 game by now.
As it is, it's a 1-1 hockey game, and we're nearing the halfway point of the first period here at Olympia. Kenny Lensman will take this face-off with Sobchak just to the left of Rutherford. Sobchak, who had been wearing number 18, is wearing number 14 this evening. Now Polonich is in for the draw. with Twyber. Comes out to the blue line. A hard slap shot is stopped. Andre DuPont really drilled it. And Rutherford gloved it and held on.
Another good save by Rutherford, and another example of the deep in your own zone, those all-important faceoffs, which Barber won there directly back to the point.
Well, the faceoff will be to the right of Rutherford. Lensman is in for the faceoff, along with Dale McCourt. Buck is loose, picked up by Barber, gets it out to the left point. A shot by DuPont is deflected, pops straight up into the air. Now tapped out to center. DuPont picks it up for the flyer. DuPont fires it into the right corner, goes in behind the net. Rutherford leaves it there for Huber. Now comes out along the right side to center. DuPont throws it to the far wing. Huber picks it up at center. And Huber drills it off the boards into the flyer's end. The Flyers bring it ahead. As Lindsen falls down, the puck comes up to center ice, and it's just dumped into the corner by Bill Barber. Rutherford now leaves it for Polonic coming by. Polonic to the left side, back to the right to Huber. Huber trying to get a board pass off to Sobchak. Huber picks up the loose puck, takes it into the Flyers' end, tries a stick handle through, but it's knocked off his stick by Daly and goes to the corner. Now Kelly is into the corner, and they jab it up there, and there's a little fog developing down. That's one of the ice at the moment. Well, on the faceoff coming up to the left of Phil Meyer.
Ryan, what are you doing?
Sir, behold, the cheddar bacon Uncle Burger.
Sirloin patty, cheddar cheese, and bacon. Well, it's...
Yes. Yes, it is.
Seriously?
Well, I've never been more serious in my life. Look at me.
The new Cheddar Bacon Uncle Burger. Seriously, at A&W.
Ford has pulled off a game changer.
It's the Ford Taurus.
The new Ford Taurus.
Just look at it.
Loaded with the latest technology.
Blind spot monitoring.
Cross-traffic alert system.
Sync voice activation.
Push-button start.
Rear-view backup camera.
Six-speed paddle shifting.
I can get it in all-wheel drive.
Loaded.
It's loaded.
Fun to drive.
Fuel efficient.
It's powerful.
It's today. I love the new Taurus.
The 2010 Taurus.
Only from Ford.
This is Ford today. Drive one.
When the time comes, you'll know. You'll know that all the training, the hard work, and the sweat was worth it. But mostly you'll know about patience. And you'll be glad you do. Because knowing you're one punch away from victory is the sweetest part of the sweet science.
Rated T for Team.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
Imagine. 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 Imagine.
Lotto 649's next jackpot is $15 million.
Brownie batter blizzard, brownie batter blizzard, brownie batter blizzard, brownie batter blizzard.
Hmm. Delicious and a tongue twister.
The Brownie Batter Blizzard. Creamy DQ soft serve blended with gooey brownie batter and chocolatey brownie pieces.
I think Joe is hurt. Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! It is over! It is over in the second round! George Foreman is the heavyweight champion of the world!
You're watching ESPN Classic.
Buck comes back to Bergman. He dumps it into the Flyers' end. Meyer leaves it behind the net. Picked up there by Bob Daly. Ahead it comes to center ice. And dumped into the Red Wings' end and bumped off the puck. Glenn Hicks comes loose, comes out to center behind Mahovlich. Controlled by Propp. Propp along the near board, spun around by Larson. And we're going to have a penalty coming up, I believe, against Larson for holding. Be the first penalty of the hockey game as Larson goes off, 2 minutes for holding. And it'll be Kenny Lensman in with the Wings, Dale McCourt. Back to McLeish. Place along the near board. Pop trying to dig it out. Comes loose. Picked up by Lesman. Skating in. He shoots. And a good save made by Rutherford. And it's cleared out by Mahovlich, but not far enough. It's kept in. And Rutherford is called upon for another save. Daly keeps it in at the right point. A bouncing puck, and Mahovlich finally clears it out. Now McLeish goes back to his own end. The court is with him. Gets it ahead to Prop. Now comes on left wing to Lensman. Lensman, drop pass, moving in. Prop with a shot. It's deflected. A big scramble and a goal for the Philadelphia Flyers. And there was a big scramble there. I'm not exactly sure. I don't know whether you caught it or not, Mickey. Who will get credit for the goal?
I believe it was Big Paul Holmgren. He was parked in front of the net. I think the puck had caught down on their feet. Tommy Bergman didn't have them tied up, and he reached back and shoveled it into the net.
Maybe you're right. It was Paul Holmgren who just reached out and tapped it in. A power play goal for the Philadelphia Flyers to give them a 2-1 lead with 5:42 left in the first period. So the faceoff at center ice as the Wings find themselves down by a goal once again. Dale McCord and Rick McLeish with a draw. Comes back to Willie Huber. Huber dumps it in the right wing corner. Sails around behind the net on the far side. And it's cleared out immediately by Dennis Vervegaard. Huber at center. Dumps it into the Flyers end. Picked up on the far end by Barnes. He puts it right on the stick of Daniel Broughton. A little fog down there. Dug out by McCord. McCord can't center, however. It's poked away. Dale gets it back. Up to the near side, and it's cleared up into the Flyers' bench.
Well, a good bit of work by McCourt there, Larry. If he could have got that puck over to Foligno, I think we might have had a good shot on goal. But some good stick handling by Dale McCourt.
The assists on the goal by Holmgren go to Prop and Lensman. The time of the goal, 14-18. That was Holmgren's fifth goal of the season, making it a 2-1 hockey game here at Olympia. Face off to the left of Meyer. Dale McCord in for the draw, along with Rick McLeish. Huber rakes it out, goes down the slot, knocked off his stick, and thrown to the far side by Barnes. A shot from the left point by Perry Miller. Sails wide into the right corner, but kept in. Now going back to the corner, DuPont. DuPont throws it to the far side, tapped in behind the net again by LeBrock. Now comes out along the near side. DuPont shoots it out to center ice. And it's loose along the near board. Miller drops it back down for Willie Huber. Huber along the near wing to Foligno. Foligno back to Miller. Miller brings it to center ice. Gives it to Foligno. Tips it into the Flyers zone, and it's tapped to the near side by McLeish and comes out to center ice. Dale McCourt circles back. Takes it off and tries to get it off to Foligno, but it's poked away to the far wing. And chasing it is Barnes. Barnes rakes it out to center ice. Now it's McCourt back by his own blue line. McCourt ahead to Huber on right wing. Didn't get much on his pass into the zone. Here's McCourt. McCourt trying to split through and has to circle back. Shoots it off the right side to Polonich. Polonich throws it behind the net over to the far wing, and the Red Wings are changing on the fly. And here come the Flyers. On the far side, it's Vervegaard. Now it's center ice. LeBrotten circles back to his own end. A little fog developing on the ice. A bad pass almost caused a problem as Holmgren. Looks like he might bore right through. Now Polonich dumps it into the Red Wings' left corner. Now bringing it up the ice, Bobby Clark. Clark brings it to center. Takes it to the right wing. The Flyers were just barely onside, and the shot by Leach is knocked down. And here come the Red Wings. Larson flying on left wing, brings it into the Flyers' zone. A drop pass is a little behind, but a shot is just through the crease and comes to the right side, where it's picked up now by Bill Barber. Barber brings it to center for the Flyers. His drop pass is intercepted and is picked up by Larson. Larson starts up the ice. He's got Polonich in right wing. Larson lets a high slap shot go. Bounces off the glass, and Clark picks it up and shoots it out to center. Now Larson in the big center circle drives it right back into the Philadelphia zone. Myers leaves it there for Watson coming by. Watson comes out to the right side, can't clear it. Here's a shot by Toby Bergman, is off to the right. A shot by Huber is deflected, and a late save made by Phil Myers. Goes to the left corner, kept in by Bergman. Goes back in behind the net. Taken there by Bosniak. Now comes out to center ice, picked up by Huber. Huber drives it back in. This is by far the best sustained effort on the part of the Red Wings in this period. They trail 2-1 with 2:34 left in the opening period. Out to Adamski. Picking it up. He's got an open wing. He's moving in. He shoots it wide to the left. Mihalic goes along the near boards to battle for it. It's jabbed up, and we'll have a face-off with Uncle Meyer.
You hoe and you rake. You shovel and you ache. And for what? Flowers that might not bloom? Forget all that work, because now you can be the envy of all your neighbors with thousands of blooms instantly, thanks to Roll and Grow, the miracle garden in a box. Just roll out our floral carpet, water, and let nature do the rest. Thousands of flowers wherever you want them. Cut Roll and Grow just like cloth to fit plant pots on the terrace or window boxes on the patio. Or cut it in half and get up to 20 feet of edging for your driveway or walk. Each Roll and Grow carpet has over 1,000 seeds and all the nutrients needed to blossom into a rainbow of fantastic flowers. Cut and place. Or just roll and grow. In weeks, you'll be surrounded with beautiful blooms. You could spend hours and hours digging and hoeing, then planting tiny seeds one by one, or spend hundreds, even thousands of dollars at a nursery, and then you still have to waste time getting them in the ground. Not with Roll and Grow. It's biodegradable, environmentally friendly, retains water, and suppresses weeds. Now that means a lot less work for you. Beautiful flowers like these can be yours quickly and easily. Just roll, water, and grow to enjoy your fabulous garden. Our 1,000 seed, 10 square foot Roll and Grow can be yours for just one single payment of $29.95. That's a lot of flowers. In fact, one 10 foot roll fills all of these window boxes. Incredible! But wait, by ordering through this special TV offer, we're going to double the seed count. That's an extra 1,000 seeds guaranteed to dazzle. Yours free when you order. 2,000 flowers, all for just $29.95. This offer is not available in stores, so call and order your Roll and Grow garden today. Call the number on your screen and bring the beauty of real flowers to your home quickly and easily with Roll and Grow, the floral carpet miracle.
Buck comes out to the left, pointed a span on by Barry Long, and it comes all the way back out to the Red Wings' end. Now Hicks picks it up. Jammed against the boards by Holmgren. Now Woods jams it out. That was Long, rather. A loose puck picked up by Mihalic. Mihalic over to the far boards. A little fog. We got a penalty coming up here against the Philadelphia Flyers, and it looks as though it'll be Val Bridgman going off. We'll see in a moment. They get a high stick call here against Val Bridgman, who will be leaving for a couple of minutes. That'll be the second penalty. Here's another look at it, Mickey.
Well, there's no question about this call, Larry. He had the stick up over the shoulders and raked it over the back of the Detroit player's head, and he's going off for 2 minutes.
That's the second penalty against the Philadelphia Flyers in this game. Correcting the first penalty, the second penalty of the game. Bridgman going off at 18:08, and the Red Wings will have a power play opportunity. Holmgren has scored a goal in each of the five games in which he has played for the Red Wings. It's 2-1 here. Pete Mihalic is on, along with Danny LeBrocken and Errol Thompson, Nedomanski, and McCourt. The Red Wings on the power play with a minute 46 left in this second period of play. Nedomanski gives it to McCourt. McCourt drops it off to LeBrocken, gets through on the left wing. His centering pass comes out to Nedomanski, winds up, shoots, good save. Rebound shot is wide off the stick of Errol Thompson. He's all the way out to center ice and back into the Red Wings' end. Rutherford way out of the goal, now misses on it. Now flips it off with his glove and tapped away and picked up by Mihalic. Here comes McCourt to Thompson on right wing. Thompson to McCourt, his shot sails very wide to the left. Mihalic out at the left point. Mihalic back into the corner. LeBrocken to Nedomanski, winds up, shoots, stick save, rebound, scores! Errol Thompson rams home the rebound to tie this game at 2-2. Errol Thompson, Mickey, was just capped to the left of Phil Meyer, and there was no problem at all to ram home the rebound.
Well, he was Johnny on the spot there, Larry. They moved that puck around real well in the Flyers' zone.
And the shot came in. The rebound came right out to Errol Thompson, standing right on the doorstep, and just banged it in the open net.
A power play goal for the Red Wings, and it's tied once again at 2-2 with a minute six left in this first period of action at Olympia. Bouncing puck comes to the near side. Clark jams it into the Red Wings' end. Bergman goes in behind his own net. Now Bergman starts it out the long. Long clears it out. Taken by DuPont. DuPont's pass is overskated by Thompson, but Thompson rakes it away for Thompson. Now Bergman. Bergman fires it into the Flyers' end. Well, here come the Flyers. It comes out to center ice. Prop. Shoots it into the Red Wings' end. Long throws it to the far side. A quick shot and a score from a very, very sharp angle by Leach. Very sharp angle, and it surprised the Red Wings' Jimmy Rutherford. And he drove it home to give the Flyers a 3-2 lead. Reggie Leach. And here's another look at it. As the puck comes out from behind the net, taken by Leach, and it's just a quick wrist shot. Sails in, a very sharp angle, and the red light goes on, and it's 3-2 Philadelphia. An unassisted goal for Leach. 19:32, the time of the goal. Well, it's battle back time once again for the Red Wings. Bergman out to Woods. Woods into the Flyer zone. Out in front, a quick shot there is deflected high into the air by Meyer. And the Red Wings are very dangerous for just a moment. As Bill Hogebaum was capped out front. That's the end of the first period of play. The Philadelphia Flyers are leading it by a score of 3-2.
Enjoy your fully loaded boxed meal.
Beep, 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 beep.
Introducing KFC's fully loaded box meal, an oversized load of KFC favorites. A Big Crunch sandwich, original recipe seasoned chicken, fries, salad, and a drink. Life tastes better with KFC.
In the war between fun and practicality, there are victims and there are victors. To the victor go the spoils. All new, all that, Mazda 3.
When the time comes, you'll know. You'll know that all the training, the hard work, and the sweat was worth it. But mostly, you'll know about patience. And you'll be glad you do. Because knowing you're one punch away from victory is the sweetest part of the sweet science.
Rated T for Teen.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
The new JVC Averio Memory Card Camcorder with dual SD card slots, one-touch upload to YouTube, and easy export to your iTunes library. The new colorful Averio Memory Card Camcorders.
The perfect experience. JVC.
They're about ready to go as Hogebaum skates in for the opening face-off with Bobby Clark, and it's controlled by the Flyers. Barnes tosses it off to the right side. Dug out by Leach momentarily and jammed up against the boards with Woods. And the whistle finally sounds. We'll have a face-off just above the Red Wings' blue line. Bill Hogebaum in for the draw with Bobby Clark. Tap back into the Red Wing end. Rutherford leaves it there for Barry Long. Throws it to the far side. Tapped out to the left point, kept in at the point momentarily by DuPont, that cleared out. Picked up on the far wing by Willie Huber. Huber shoots into the Philadelphia end, Taken there by Norm Barnes. Barnes starts it up the left wing. Goes it past the center. Off it comes Leach's stick. Here's a hard shot, a deflected shot off Ryan Popstick. Sails into the corner and comes out to the middle of the ice where it's picked up by the Red Wings. Dan Bolduc. Bolduc coming in on right wing. Bolduc had a full head of steam, just could not get by. Finally hauled out by Andre Dupont. He'll be going off for 2 minutes for holding. So the Red Wings will have the power play advantage. Here's another look, Nick.
I think that could have been a good penalty on Dupont's part, Larry. I think Bolduc, with his speed, may have had him beat on the outside and may have got in for a good opportunity on the goal. So in that case, I think maybe a good penalty that Dupont hauled him down.
The Red Wings on the power play in the early moments of the second period, trailing by a score of 3-2. Vasilov Adamansky behind his own goal. Leaves it for Pete Mihalovic. Mihalovic comes out to the right side, a bad pass, and it is almost picked off by the Flyers. Try it again. Coming up the left side, Danny LeBrocken. LeBrocken has it knocked off his stick. Mihalovic keeps it in at the left point. Mihalovic to LeBrocken. LeBrocken in the corner. LeBrocken looking in. Out it comes to the point of the court. Back to LeBrocken. Pinned against the board by Daly. Shot to the far side. It's deflected off the stick of Meyer into the corner. As Adamansky got a good hard one away, but Meyer kicked it out. Now Rutherford leaves it for Adamansky as Big Ned comes by. Gets it out to the right side. Red Wings having trouble getting it out of their own end here. A little disorganized as Mihalovic is pinned against the board. The shot is turned away by Rutherford. Now Mihalovic picks up the loose puck. 49 seconds left in the power play. Here comes Adamansky. Adamansky into the fire zone. Tries to get through. He's upended. There's no call, and the puck comes free, and here come the Flyers. Zipping up the middle of the ice for the Flyers, Bobby Clark, and he loses the puck. Here comes Adamansky. Adamansky across the blue line. That's one go, but it's deflected into the seats by Jimmy Watson. The Wings having a little trouble getting this power play organized, Mickey.
They are, Larry, but I think you've got to give Philadelphia all the credit in the world there. They're forechecking them, forcing them to make a couple of bad passes back in their own zone, and they just can't seem to get started. Of course, the key thing here with the man advantage is to get back, get set up, get a full head of steam, and get five men moving together down the ice at the same time.
26 seconds left in the Red Wings power play time. Now the Wings are bringing Perry Miller on, along with McCourt, Thompson, Mike Larson, and Thompson. Draw is won by the Flyers, and they clear it out to center. Larson goes back to pick it up near his own blue line. Miller to Foligno. There's 5 seconds of power play time left, and Larson given a lot of trouble by Bobby Clark, retreats to deepen his own end. Clark with him, and now the Flyers are back at full strength. Here comes Perry Miller. Miller has it poked away by Andre Dupont. Larson with a board pass on the left side to Harold Thompson. He's jammed against the board. Now Miller comes up with it and dumps it into the Flyers' end. Meyer grabs it. Leaves it on the far side for Watson. Out it comes on the near side. Tapped ahead to Leach, who just tips it to center, and Perry Miller is spun around. Larson takes the pass in his own end as the Flyers change on the move. Now it's Foligno to Thompson. Thompson trying to get through. Against Philadelphia. Thompson almost got through, and a holding call is coming up against Mike Bosniak.
Hi, it's Fitz with Slap Chop. You're going to be in a great mood all day because you're going to be slapping your troubles away with a Slap Chop. Now look, here's a potato. One slap, you got big chunks for stews. Two slaps, home fries in a second. You add a mushroom. The more you do it, the finer it gets. You don't have to switch any blades. You love salad. You hate making it. Take the stringy celery, take the carrots, salad. I love pizza too, but once in a while, get the veggies in. At least throw it on top of the pizza. This tuna looks boring. Stop having a boring tuna. Stop having a boring life. Here's a hard-boiled egg. One chop, you add the pickle, you add the green onion. And then what you can do, you can mix things together. You add the ham. You don't have time to make breakfast. You're gonna have an exciting life now. Breakfast to go. You're gonna love my nuts. Watch this. You can do everything in the cover. It's so easy. One finger. Kids can do it. They're gonna charge you $1 for toppings at the ice cream stores. What about fruit? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful on your ice cream? It's so easy to clean. One, two. And pops open like that, like a butterfly to clean. Now, these other ones that you've seen in the store, you can't clean it. It doesn't open up. Bacteria gets in the food. You don't want bacteria in your food, right, guys? Forget about that. Take this Slap Chop. All right, here's the garlic with the skin. There you go. These skins, the garlic, the onions with the skin. All right, this is making you cry and making me cry. Life's hard enough as it is. You don't want to cry anymore. The skin's at the bottom. Hey, look, so you want a little bit of onions? You don't want to drag out the food processor? The skin comes right off. We're going to make America skinny again. One slap at a time. When you buy the Slap Chop, we're gonna give you the Grady for cheese. White cheese, yellow cheese, in the container. Comes with a twister, and watch this. Tacos, fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini. Comes with two blades, just bang it, fine and coarse. Parmesan, comes with a cover, stay sealed. Put it in the fridge, take it out when you need it. Slap Chop sells for $19.95, but if you call now, within the next 20 minutes, because you know we can't do this all day, you're going to get the Grady absolutely free. Just pay for processing. Here's how to order.
Call the number on your screen to get in on this amazing offer. You get the Slap Chop for just $19.95. And when you call in the next 20 minutes, you'll get the Grady for free. Just pay processing. Be like Vince and slap your troubles away with Slap Chop. Call now and get slapping.
And the Wings are on the power play as Buzniak goes off for holding. Bridgman and Mahovlich. McCourt to Mahovlich, got off the end of his stick. He's being wrestled around by Bridgman, and it's picked up by Daly. Daly tries to clear, kept in at the right point by Larson. Drilled in behind the Flyers' net, and it's picked up by Mahovlich. Mahovlich breaks it in, shoots! Good save by Meyer. Excellent effort on the part of Mahovlich. He looked like he was going to turn the red light on. Tucked in behind the Flyers' net, and the whistle sounds. We'll have a face-off coming up to the left of Meyer. Looked like Big Peter was ready to score.
A real good chance by Mahovlich. A heck of a play coming out of the corner and stepping around the one defenseman. A real good save by Phil Mirror. This game would have been tied 3-3, Larry.
Face-off to the left of Mirror. Mahovlich and Bridgman. Goes into the corner. Picked up by the Flyers. Bill Bates, who tried to clear, couldn't do it. Mahovlich's centering pass is high. It's deflected past Nedimansky, and the Red Wings can't keep it in. It just crossed the blue line before Larson could get to it. A minute 12 left in the Red Wings power play. Again, it'll be Bridgman and Mahovlich for the faceoff. Bobby Crowman, the referee, are having a little ongoing tete-a-tete here, and referee Medill pointed at him, and Dillon had had enough. A little fog developing on the ice now. Puck picked up by Bill Barber as the Red Wings again are having a little trouble getting this power play going. Shot back into the Wings' end. LeBrocken goes back after it. LeBrocken moves it up the ice to Nedimansky to McCourt. The right wing to LeBrocken. He's moving in. Centering pass underneath Mahovlich's stick. A backhander by Nedimansky. Hits the post and it goes into the corner. Nedimansky out to Larson. A hard shot sailed wide. Bouncing puck in front. A loose puck in the slot. A backhander. Good save by Mayer. Off the stick of LeBrocken. And it comes out to center and back into the Red Wings' end. And the Red Wings did just about everything but score on that flurry. 20 seconds left in the power play. Here come the Wings once again. Moved out to center ice. To LeBrocken, he's flying! He's in! A wide open net. Dug out on the far side now by Sobchuk. A shot, Mirror knocks it away again. LeBrocken goes to the corner. Unpicked up by Larson. And now the Flyers are back at full strength. A shot by McCourt hits the post and comes back out to Dale at the blue line. His shot knocked down by Nedobansky, bouncing to the right side. McCourt goes after it, drills it to the corner, comes around to the near side. Now it's picked up on the near side, trying to clear it out is Barnes. And finally, the Philadelphia Flyers take a little pressure off Bill Mayer. We're getting a whistle, and we're going to have a face-off coming up at center ice. Tough break for the Wings in a wide open net.
Larry, but this Philadelphia club, going back a few years ago, they always like to play that rough, the rough style of hockey, and you've got to try and take advantage of those power plays, or they'll continue it all night long.
Pat Quinn, the head coach of the Flyers, behind the bench for Philadelphia. 3-2 is the score, 14:05 left in the second period. Philadelphia leads. Tommy Bergman dumps it into the Flyers' end. Knocked it out to center ice. Bergman knocked it down. Thompson. Thompson bumps off by Propp. Getting a little foggy down there now. Milanich dumps it into the Flyers' end. Daly goes back. Daly tries to clear it out, does, but puts it right on a Red Wing stick. And Willie Huber fires it back in. A bouncing puck got away from Mayer for a moment. And picked up by a base. He clears it to center. Bergman takes it there. Bergman drops it back to Huber. Huber to Polanich on the far side. Back to Big Willie. Willie now gives it to Thompson. Thompson tried to get a Polanich, and it was intercepted by Propp. Now loose at center. Now we got a penalty coming up here against the Red Wings. Wilson went down, and we undoubtedly will get a tripping call here. Nope, it's going to be a hooking call, and it'll be against Big Willie Huber. So now the Flyers, who are so effective as penalty killers, will have the power play advantage of their own as Willie Huber takes two. Here's another look at the penalty, Mickey. Well, this, we're not going to get the penalty. We're going to get the flurry on the power play that the Red Wings had.
Good save there by Mira. It could have been a goal by Danny LeBratton. Very close in front.
Time of the penalty on Huber, 6:43. Of the second period. The Flyers are on the attack. Here comes Big Bob Daly. Buck goes into the corner, chased by Holmgren. On a ball, Holmgren with a shot knocked high into the air off Rutherford's stick, and it is cleared by Tommy Bergman into the seats. Now you can really see the fog on your screen now as it develops on the Red Wing end. Very warm, very humid here at Olympia tonight.
Well, if it gets any worse, Larry, they may have to stop the game and get everybody out there and skate around to get that fog moving around and get out of one spot on the ice.
Well, I think they're going to referee is over talking with Pat Quinn right now. Quinn is very unhappy about something, and that's what they're going to do. They're going to get the players out and skate around a little bit, as you suggested, Mickey, to get the fog dispersed. Pat Quinn is unhappy about something, and Bobby Crom was very unhappy just a few moments ago and had a little tete-a-tete with the referee.
Well, I think in that case, they had the Red Wings on the power play, had the play down in the Philadelphia end for the last minute or so, and as a result, you get a lot of fog build up down in the Red Wings zone.
See Mike Foligno, the youngster, talking with Bobby Crom before he left the players' bench. Everybody on the ice for both teams now, or virtually everyone, skating around to see if they can break it up. 3-2 is the score. The Flyers leading the Red Wings.
Some things are just meant to be together. Tim Horton's hot breakfast sandwich, served in a freshly baked biscuit or bagel. Always a great value. Always Tim Hortons.
Imagine.
Lotto 649's next jackpot is $15 million.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Hey,
but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda Checkered Flag event fast.
Hi, this is Chuck Storm. I'm live at the scene where last night there was a robbery at about 3:30 in the morning. Now, police have...
This wind is messing up my hair. Oh, don't give me that look. Watch the road. Great. Now look what you've done. I told you not to drive so...
For drivers who want to get the most out of their cars, it's Bridgestone or nothing.
Looks like we're about ready to go again as Big Pete Mahovlich skates in for the face-off with Mel Bridgman to the right of Jimmy Rutherford. Goes to the corner. Holmgren skates in, pinned against the board by Larson. Mahovlich comes up to the front, throws it along to the near side. On the air board, Staley is battling for possession. Now taken by Holmgren. Holmgren out to the left point. Teed up by Mike Faith, lets it fly, deflected it behind, popped up in the air. Rutherford can't hang on to it, and it goes in for a goal. Boy, there was a big crowd there, as Rutherford, I think, is claiming that someone was in the goalie's crease as he goes over to talk with the referee. A big crowd out in front of Rutherford, who made the initial save and popped up into his out of his glove, and he did not grab on. We'll get another look.
Again, Larry, here's that guy, Paul Holmgren again, parked right in front of Jimmy Rutherford, fighting for the puck down there, and as Jimmy came up, it dropped out of his trapper, and Holmgren just banged it in the open side. But those are the kind of opportunities you can get by standing around the front of that net.
Makes it a 4-2 hockey game. The Flyers leading Detroit as Holmgren gets his second goal of the game. Hicks picks it up for the Red Wings. Takes it to the right side. Leaves it now for Woods. Woods starts it ahead. To Mahovlich. Mahovlich at center to Nedimansky. Working one-on-one. His shot is knocked down by Bates. Goes to the far wing. Nedimansky rakes it out. Nedimansky gives it to the left side to Hicks. His shot knocked down by Meir. And he covers it up immediately. The time of the goal by Holmgren was 9:27 of the second period. Assists to Bridgman. And Dorrance. Again, we have a delay as the skaters zip around their Olympia to clear up the fog that has developed on the Philadelphia end. We have 9:57 left in the second period of play. The Flyers leading it by a score of 4-2. Red Wings have not led in this game. They fell behind, tied it, fell behind, tied it, and have now fallen two goals behind. Holmgren now has six goals in five games for the Flyers, with his two tonight. Mahovlich taking the faceoff with Rick McLeish. This to the right of Phil Meir. Goes to the corner. Buzniak is there and is jammed up against the boards, and again we'll have a face-off as Hicks came in to help freeze the puck against the corner boards. And again it'll be McLeish and Mahovlich, the face-off to the right of Meir. Goes to the corner, taken there by Garth. Thrown to the far side. And here come the Flyers on left wing. It's Rick McLeish. He dumps it into the Red Wings end, and a lot of fog developing there. Bergard throws it to the far side. Picked up by Nedimansky. Pins against the boards there by Kelly. Now here comes Curry Miller. Miller to the right side. It's past Nedimansky. And picked picked up by Mahovlich. Mahovlich takes a shot, now gets one away, and is deflected to the right. Pete goes in behind a center. He passed just too far for Mahovlich to handle and comes all the way out to center. Rivergard throws it to the far side. And a shot by Kelly is hard off the backboard. Rutherford out, throws it along the near boards, comes out along the right to Barnes, gets away from Kev and comes to center. Leach picks it up. Now Nedimansky knocks it down and controls the Red Wings at center. Nedimansky got it tangled up with Woods' skates. It's a loose puck as Woods goes back, along with McLeish. Here's Miller. Miller ahead to Woods. Ball feeds past one. Here's two on one. Off it goes. Woods shot. It's down right here. Goes to the far side where Barnes digs it out. Barnes ahead now to the right. Going to the left side, a shot by Lensman is wide to the right. And dug out now by the Red Wings. Comes to center, taken by Barber. Lensman on left wing, dumps it into the Detroit zone. Paul Woods brings it up the middle. Almost tied up. His pass is too far out front of Bolduc. And it's loose at center. Now Bolduc goes to the far board with Bill Barber. Into the corner, in behind the net. A shot covered up by Rutherford, and he hangs on. A little pushing and shoving here as Holmgren is jammed against the cross piece. But nothing is going to come of this.
In the war between fun and practicality, there are victims and there are victors. To the victor, go the spoils. All new, all that, Mazda 3.
I'm John Scherer, CEO and founder of Video Professor. I'm the guy that gives away the free computer learning lessons. Well, today I'm here to tell you about a great new product that many of you have been asking for. And here it is, how to buy and sell on eBay, and I'll give it to you free. Now, I'm not going to tell you that I can make you the next millionaire selling an attic full of baseball cards, but I can guarantee you that I'll teach you everything you need to know about eBay, while cleaning out your garage and probably putting some money in your pocket at the same time. Now, I can do this because I know that once you try my lesson on eBay, you'll be so satisfied that the next time you need to learn anything about computers, you'll come back to Video Professor for all your computer learning needs. And with over 55 lessons on all of today's most popular computer programs, I know that there's more you'll want to learn. Don't forget, call now and I'll send you eBay or any other lesson of your choice free. So what do you got to lose? Try my product.
Call 1-800-671-2660. That's 800-671-2660.
Ryan, what are you doing?
Sir, behold, the cheddar bacon Uncle Burger.
Sirloin patty, cheddar cheese, and bacon. Well, it's...
Yes. Yes, it is.
Seriously?
Well, I've never been more serious in my life. Look at me.
The new cheddar bacon Uncle Burger. Seriously, at A&W.
7:57 left in the second period. Philadelphia 4, Detroit 2. Face off to the right of Rutherford. Jimmy tips it to the corner. Willie Huber goes after it. Throws it over the far side. Puts it right on her flyer stick. And it comes out to the left point. A shot by DuPont. Knocked down. Here come the Red Wings. Thompson with a drop pass. And Sobchak was knocked down before he could get the shot away. The Flyers on the move. Barber into the left corner, picked up by Huber. Huber trying to clear it out, gets underneath the flyer stick at the blue line and does come to center. Tapped back in by Holmgren, picked up now by Lensman. Lensman leaves it off for Barber. Barber shoots it wide. And it's cleared out on the far side by Polonic. Now big Willie Huber comes to center. Huber dumps it into the Flyers' left corner. Here is it for Daly. Daly tries to get it to Leach, picked up by Thompson. Thompson trying to get it to Balanich, but it's broken up by Daly. Coming in on the right side, moving quickly, his shot. His shot is good. Score for Philadelphia, makes it 5-2. Now as he came in from the right side, Vicki.
Just a tremendous play by Bobby Clark here. Prop going down his off wing, took the pass from Clark, hit him in full stride, and he had the Detroit defenseman standing still up at the blue line. He just walked around him and fired it high again, the same place as his first goal, right over Jimmy's left shoulder, off the crossbar and down into the net. But a heck of a shot for the young kid.
That's the second goal of the night for Brian Prop as he got in behind Tommy Brigman. The assist going to Clark and Daly, and the goal coming at 13-12 of the second period to make it 5-2. The Flyers lead Detroit. Long, the far side, driven into the... Oh, almost. Foligno let one fly. And Mirror had a few problems. A lot of fog again in the Philadelphia end. Now Foligno at center has it knocked off his stick by Leach. Goes to the Detroit end. Larson skates in. Larson being chased by Bobby Clark. Loses it to Clark. Clark in the right corner tries to center it, and it's picked up by Reed Larson. Out it comes to center. On the right side, LeBrock lines up, shoots. It's hard off the glass and comes out to center ice. Long. On the near side, tries to get it to LeBrock. Goes too far, but Court goes into the corner with Bates. They jam it up there, and we'll have a faceoff coming up to the right of Phil Mayer. 5:50 left in the second period. Philadelphia leads it by a score of 5-2. Faceoff to the right of Mayer. The McCourt in for the draw with Rick McLeish. Holmgren and Prop with two goals each now for the Flyers as we reach the late stages of the second period here in Olympia. Puck picked up by McLeish. McLeish sends it down the ice. Chased down by Barry Long. Gets it out on the left and a throw to the right, and McLeish will take it off the boards. Gets the shot off. Rutherford kicks it in the corner. Picked up there by Bob Kelly. Now it's loose in the slot. A quick right-hander by Vervegaard. Just kicked away by Rutherford. Back to the top of the left point. It gets away from Watson. And the Flyers have to come back and get onside. Trying to sweep it aside. Loose puck to the corner. LeBrock goes in. Again, the Red Wings having trouble against the Flyers getting it out. And here comes the court. Off to LeBrock. Too far for LeBrock. But he catches up and tries to turn it in. Flyers stop it and leaves it for Watson. Watson starts out the right side. Gives it to Holmgren. Holmgren to center, dumps it into the wing's left corner as the Flyers change on the move. McCourt throws it ahead to Nedimansky. LeBrock. LeBrock up to Big Man. This shot knocked down by DuPont. And it's controlled by the Flyers. Now Bridgman. Bridgman to the right side. 4:04 left in the second period here. Willie Hilber in the corner. Goes it to the near side. And it's set the length of the ice. And we'll get an icing call against the Detroit Red Wings. The Wings are having their problems in their all end, Mickey.
Well, I think they're not playing together right now, Larry. We're getting the one-man rushes, and there's just no way. The way Philadelphia is playing, they're having two men on the puck all the time, and the Wings are just not getting together and skating together. They're coming up sporadically. One's up, or one's back, or two up and one back, and they're going to need everybody going together to get some good opportunities to get back in the game.
Mahovlich and Bridgman will take this faceoff as Philadelphia leads it 5-2, 3:48 left in the second period. That's Jimmy Rutherford in goal, and there's Big Pete. Puck picked up by the wings. This is Nedimansky. Drops it off for Hicks. Hicks with a shot knocked down by the defense, and it comes out to center. Miller to Huber. Back to Miller. Miller along the near boards. back to the Red Wing end, and Miller throws it again to the right side to Huber. Huber lets it fly from the red line. Long rebound coming off, and it's cleared out immediately. Red Wings haven't had a lot of success here from the midpoint of the second period on, controlling the puck. Here's Mahovlich firing good. He's called out. There's no penalty coming up. Mahovlich broke the stick and has to come to the bench to pick up a new one. Now here comes Dorrance. Dorrance loses it to Hicks. Dorrance fires it back into the Red Wings end. 2:58 left in the second period. Miller gives it to Huber. Huber goes to the corner along with Paul Holmgren. They tie it up there and we'll have a faceoff to the right of Rutherford.
I need you to start cleaning up your...
Oh. The brownie batter blizzard at Dairy Queen. Gooey brownie
That's
batter.
Moist brownies. Hey, guys, you want to go to DQ? I'll buy you both a blizzard.
Okay.
Start the car.
This is the best idea you ever had.
Yeah, I recorded a cheeseburger one for Dad.
It'll get you every time. The DQ brownie batter blizzard. Now try our new Sweet Deals value menu.
I figure the engineers who built the all-new 09 F-150 are probably the same guys we all cheated off of in science class. We're thinking about pizza. They're thinking about aerodynamic wake properties. Crazy smart. Take fuel economy, for example. They gave it 29 miles per gallon. You can't get a truck with better mileage. And they didn't give up an ounce of power to get it. In fact, they actually increased the horsepower. Now that is some A-plus truck thinking. It's not just a new truck. It's a new F-150.
When the time comes, you'll know. You'll know that all the training, the hard work, and the sweat was worth it. But mostly, you'll know about patience. And you'll be glad you do. Because knowing you're one punch away from victory is the sweetest part of the sweet science.
Rated T for Team. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Hugabaum and Lindsman with the faceoff to the right of Jimmy Rutherford. 2:50 left in the second period. The Flyers lead it 5-2. Thrown into the right corner, taken there by Larson. Gets it to Woods. Woods can't handle. Larson gets it back. Larson throws it along the far side to Bolduc. He goes down, and we've got a whistle. A face-off coming up above the circle to the right of Jimmy Rutherford with 2:36 left in the period. A hot, humid night at Olympia. Lensman and Hogabob with a face-off. Hogabob finally gets it out to Woods. Woods across the blue line, brings it left side, gets a shot away, stick save, rebound! Good save, but
Bolduc
came pouring right down the slot and rammed it home.
Well, Paul Wood set this play up here with his shot. He let the puck go between the legs of the defenseman. A screenshot that Phil Mir couldn't control. The rebound came right back out to Bolduc, and he slammed it high into the net. Good save by Mir on the original shot. Right out to Bolduc, and he fires it high over Phil Mir, who couldn't get it. Didn't have a chance on the shot.
Makes it a 5-3 hockey game. The Flyers leading with 2:18 left in the second period. Here come the Flyers. Racing down the right side, Lindsman. Lindsman shoots it to the far wing. Into the left corner. 2:05 left in the second period of play. The assists on the goal by Bolduc going to Hogeboom and Woods. And the time is 17:35. Woods gets the shot away, but it's knocked down by the defense. comes off near the blue line. Zobchuk keeps it in. Now comes back out to center. Bolduc fires it back, and the Wings were offside.
Big goal for the Wings, Larry. I think being down 5-2 before that goal, it was really important for them to get one before going in at the end of the second period. So I think it may give them a little bit of life, but you may see them come out charged at the start of the third period.
We'll have another free skate here as they break up the fog a little bit. Let's go back and play hockey. Flyers continue to circle in front of Phil Bear. That's where the fog is located. 1:47 left in the second period. Flyers lead the Wings 5-3. Zobchuk taking the face off with Bobby Clark. Behind the net, picked up there by the Flyers' Frank Bates. DuPont lobs it into the Red Wings' end. Rutherford taps it to the near side. Picked up by Errol Thompson. Goes to the far wing. And back to Sobchuk. Sobchuk at center ice. Moves it off to the far wing. And Willie Hilbert throws it into the higher end. Minute 16 left in the second period. Clark clears it out. Long knocks it down at center. Thompson throws it back into the Flyers end, where DuPont picks it up and throws it along the glass on the far side, still rolling. Hubert knocks it down, Palage in the corner. They're going to call the Red Wings for advancing the puck with a hand. It will go back out to center ice with a faceoff with 1 minute left in the second period. Three hockey game. The Flyers are leading the Detroit Red Wings. Now the Red Wings are changing as the court will not come on. Larson checking in. Curry Miller is on. And Mike Foligno is on the far wing. Buck goes into the Flyers' end with 57 seconds left in the period. Barnes ahead to Clark. Right side to Leach, winds up, shoots it wide to the left, comes all the way out to center ice. DuPont picks it up there. DuPont back to Barnes. Barnes ahead, intended for Holmgren, got under his stick, or Leach's stick, rather. 38 seconds left of the period. And McCourt goes back to pick it up. McCourt eludes a check, taps it out to center. Picked up there by Foligno. Back it comes now across the blue line into the Philadelphia zone, and it's cleared out immediately into the crowd just to the left of the Philadelphia bench. With 23 seconds remaining, it's 5-3 Philadelphia. The Red Wings have never led in this game. They have tied the score twice after falling behind. McCourt taking the face off at center ice with Mel Bridgman. Bates clears it out to center. Larson ramps it right back in, and the Red Wings are offside. 14 seconds remaining. Curry Miller skating back. Coming back following injury that sidelined him for a period of time a year ago. McCourt and Bridgman, a pair of number 10 with a space off at center ice. Daly. Daly trying to get it to Bridgman, intercepted by McCourt. Bridgman knocks it off his stick. Miller, 4 seconds left. And that is the end of the second period. Philadelphia Flyers lead the Detroit Red Wings by a score of 5-3.
Imagine.
Lotto 649's next jackpot is $15 million.
Dudes, check it.
Oh, your new domain name and website from GoDaddy.com?
Yep, and now that I'm online, it's like I can make anything happen.
Danica Patrick.
Suddenly I have the urge to take another shower.
This is awesome!
Keep watching.
This is my fifth shower today.
Steamy.
Steamy? Let's add the German woman from the dean's office.
Miss Schmidt.
Clark is floating back and forth between his two wings, and will be skating out in this third period of actually getting underway in a moment. Bill Hogaboom and Bobby Clark. Clark loose at center, dug out by Clark. Clark races the right wing. A quick shot by Reggie Leach. Knocked down by Rutherford, goes in behind. Taken by Prop. Rutherford taps it behind the net. And Hubert takes it right through the slot and takes it to the left side. Moves it out to center ice, broken up by DuPont. DuPont dumps it in, picked up by Long. Now Huber on the right, tips it ahead to Bolduc. Danny loses the puck, and it's picked up by Rick McLean, by Clark. Now looks at center. Clark fires it back into the Red Wing end, goes to the right corner. Long. We're in a little trouble with a bouncing puck. Now flies it out to Wood. Wood across the blue line, bumped off the puck by Kenny Lindsman. Now it's fired to the Flyers end, where it's taken by DuPont. Comes out to center ice. Bolduc knocks it down. Flyers trying to get something started now. Goes to the right side. A shot sails into the left corner. Lindsman takes it there. Now coming out on the near side is Hogaboom. He fires a lead pass off on the left side to Hicks. And it's knocked away by Mayer. Flyers. Quick shot by Barber. Glove by Rutherford. Drops it. Leaves it for Hicks coming by. Out to Mahovlich. He clears it to center. Taken by Daly. On Adamansky. Adamansky. Into the Flyers zone. A backhander. Knocked away by Mayer. A bouncing puck is on top of the net. And we've got a whistle and a stoppage in play.
There's Big Adamansky. Come in the backhand, let a good shot go, low on the short side, and he just caught the outside of the goalpost, and then batted it in front and went out Phil Mir, and instead of going in, it jumped up on top, and the play was called. Almost a goal by number 20.
It's 5-3, 18-18 left of the hockey game. Face off to the left of Phil Mir. Mahovlich in for the draw. Along with Dennis Grevegaard. Dumps it in. Rutherford stops it, fires it right back out near the blue line. Didn't get out. Mahovlich still to the boards on the far side. Buck is still loose. Picked up by Holmgren and inadvertently is cleared out of the zone. Bates goes back. Clears it out of the zone. Goes back into the Red Wing end, and Rutherford out of the goal mouth sweeps it to the near side. Taken by Holmgren. And almost cleared it out. Watson kept it in. Out in front, a shot. Good save by Rutherford. Off the stick of Mel Bergman. It comes out to center. Here's Adamansky. Adamansky into the Flyer zone. His shot sails wide to the left. Mahovlich on the far board. Centering pass out front. Back it comes out to Adamansky. His centering pass is turned away to the near side. Larson lets one fly. It's deflected up into the seat.
Well, the Wings with a little flurry there, Larry. Looks like they're trying to get involved real early in the period and trying to get back and make it a one-goal hockey game.
We think it was important to get that first goal early here in this third period to narrow the gap to one. Flyers leading at 5-3, 17-19 left in the game. McLeish and McCourt face off above the circle to the left of Phil Mir. Flyers control. Now Huber at center. Left side to LeBrotten. LeBrotten across. Intended for Molino. Got away from him and goes in behind the net. Molino was coming right down the spot. Looks like he might have a shot, but he couldn't handle the puck. Now here's Tommy Bergman having a little trouble getting it started. Huber goes back. McLeish on the ice forechecking. Huber on the right. Starts it up to McCourt. McCourt pass intercepted by McLeish at center. Now McLeish lobs it in and offside is the call. 16:37 left in the hockey game. The Flyers lead it 5-3.
Here's Dennis Palance, Larry, and he's playing the right side tonight. I'm sure Dennis would love to get a good opportunity on goal. Talking to him this morning, he said he'd had a few chances on the games he played on the West Coast trip, but looking forward to putting that thing in the net out there.
Sobchak will take the faceoff here at center ice. Comes back into the wing's end. Larson with it. Cleared out to center. Lob high into the air. Bouncing puck rolling into the left corner. A pop turned around. Clark goes behind the net. Out to the right point. To the barn. He keeps it in. Now taken by Leach. Into the corner, Sobchak. Comes to the right side to Polanich. Polanich has got a delay penalty coming up against the Flyers, and the puck is shot up into the crowd, so the Red Wings are not in a position to get that extra man on during that last rush. Rutherford came roaring out of the goal mound on the delay call, but the Wings were not able to get another man on before Polanich fired it up into the seat.
Looks like a slashing call to Bobby Clark, Larry. The play had happened at center ice, and I don't think too many people saw it.
Adamaski, McCourt, and it looks like LeBrocton for the Wings to begin this power play. Adamaski at center. Goes into the left side, LeBrocton gives it to McCourt. McCourt dumps it in and chases. Near leaves it now for Bates. Bates goes to the corner with McCourt. LeBrocton digs it out. Out it comes to the left point to Adamaski on the right. His shot is steered to the right side. A rebound missed by Foligno. McCourt fires. Foligno gets it back. Foligno fires. And it's loved by Mir, and he hangs on. Big
save, big save by Mir there. Mike Foligno pulled the puck in front of the net. Got a good backhand shot away. But Phil Mir was right there to make the stop. Adamaski back in the point. Takes the shot. It comes right in front of the net. Dale McCourt takes a shot. Good save by Mir. And over to Foligno, who pulls it by Frank Bays on the backhand and gets a good shot away and another good save by Mir.
The attendance tonight, 15,417. A new opening game record here at Olympia. Well, they're hooping it up a little bit now, trying to help the Red Wings to that goal that would be needed to narrow the gap to 5-4. Pavlich and Bridgman to the left of Mir. Now Mir has spotted a hole in the ice, or something apparently was thrown onto the ice. A minute 32 left in the Wings power play. Goes to the corner. Bates cleared out of the zone, and the Wings have to chase it down. McCourt being followed by Barber. McCourt chased by Bridgman. Now McCourt to Nedimansky. Nedimansky brings it up the middle. And his pass is bad, and the Wings will have to come back and get onside. The Flyers met the Red Wings four abreast across the red line that trip. Here comes McCourt. McCourt to Nedimansky. Back to McCourt. McCourt with a backhander. Beer knocks it down. Loose puck. Follow up. Goes into the right corner. And it comes to the near side. Bridgman rakes it out and skates it out of the zone. Turned around by Foligno, and Foligno is going to be called for a penalty for holding. So there goes the power play opportunity the Red Wings had.
Well, this is a bad penalty on Mike Foligno's part, Larry. With the man advantage now in the third period here, he didn't need to pull the man down puck at center ice area. All he was going to do was rag the puck, but he stuck his stick underneath his arm and just hauled him down and just nullified their power play opportunity. There he is. He just put the arm on him and dragged him down, and really not necessary to do in that case.
Time of the penalty on Foligno, 5:10 of the third period. So the two teams will be skating four aside for the next 44 seconds, and then the Flyers will have the power play. Sobchak is on the ice. Now Bobby Crown making some changes. Adamaski back on along with Pavlich, Larson, and Perry Miller. Face off at center ice, the Wings trail 5-3. On the right side with a puck of Doran pinned into the board by Larson. The puck is jammed up against the board, and we'll have a face off to the left of Jimmy Rutherford. We have Pete Pavlich and Rick McLeish with the draw. 40 left in this hockey game at Olympia. Now in for the faceoff, Paul Holmgren. Raked out by the wing, Zenovansky. He drops it back now to Mahovlich. Mahovlich to center. He's got Larson on the right wing. And tried to dump a centering pass, but it was broken up by the Flyers. And here comes Philadelphia. Off to the right side it goes to Holmgren. Behind that, Holmgren. Jabbed up against the board by Larson. Mahovlich trying to pick it out. The puck comes free, and Adamowski picks it up. Adamowski gives it to Mahovlich. 3-on-3 as Mahovlich takes it into the zone. Tries to switch to defense. Almost got through. He's hauled out. And the puck comes free. And it's picked up by Holmgren. Looks like Mahovlich might be all the way through for a shot on goal, but a good defensive play. Stop the rush. In behind the net, taken by Holmgren. Has it knocked away by Perry Miller. Miller is hauled down from behind. It comes out to the left point and drilled to the right corner by Propp. Out to the right point. Daly shot turned away by Rutherford. Another shot off Rutherford's chest. Goes to the far side. Daly tries to keep it in. Knocked up by Miller. Miller dives, trying to get it over to Nedomansky, but can't do it. Larson loses the puck. Picked up now by Barber. Goes in. Shoots. Good save made by Rutherford. Is knocked out and held on to by another wing who was sprawling on the far side. I believe it was Perry Miller. What a play.
And McCoy threw it across the blue line, and Larson just overskated the puck and allowed Barber to walk right in on Jimmy Rutherford. Couldn't get the puck up, and it hit Jimmy, bounced up in the air and right back into his trapper.
Now Rutherford did make the catch. I thought that Miller had fallen on it. A little deceptive here on this angle.
Enjoy your fully loaded box meal.
Beep, 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 beep.
Introducing KFC's fully loaded box meal, an oversized load of KFC favorites. A Big Crunch sandwich, original recipe seasoned chicken, fries, salad, and a drink. Life tastes better with KFC.
They look great.
But it's more than great-looking cars.
It's smart design.
It's things like hands-free voice activation.
Sync.
Hands-free calling.
It's Sony audio systems.
Look at this dash.
It's all digital. I've never seen anything like that.
You get in and you think, this is a Ford?
Where have I been?
It's definitely Ford.
Unmistakable.
Unbelievable. Unstoppable.
And Ford's bringing the European cars over here.
Fiesta.
It's exciting.
You've just got to see it.
This is Ford today. Drive one.
Hi, this is Chuck Storm. I'm live at the scene where last night there was a robbery at about 3:30 in the morning. Now, police have heard...
When the time comes, you'll know. You'll know that all the training, the hard work, and the sweat was worth it. But mostly, you'll know about patience. And you'll be glad you do. Because knowing you're one punch away from victory is the sweetest part of the sweet science.
Rated T for Teen. EA Sports. It's in the game.
The new JVC Averio hard drive camcorder. Share your videos with one-touch upload to YouTube and easy export to your iTunes library. The all-new JVC Averio hard drive camcorder.
The perfect experience. JVC.
Face off the left of Rutherford. Fires controlling the puck. A hard shot by Reggie Leach. Knocked away by Rutherford. Comes out to the left point. Barber with a shot. Goes straight up into the air. Bouncing along the near boards. Propp has it. Propp in behind. Gets away from Clark. Leach and Mahovlich go to the far side. Back to Clark behind the net. Clark being chased by Long. And a shot and a score by Reggie Leach. He was right out in front and got a good centering pass. And he just lifted it over Jimmy Rutherford to make it 6-3.
Well, that was a good play by Bobby Clark, Larry, and that behind the net, him and Reggie Leach worked so well together. He had Jimmy down and Canopy the side of the net. Clark got the puck behind the net to start it off with. being a man short, they can't really go after him. They tried to, but he found Leach just on the right side, and Jimmy was halfway down, and Leach just put it up. Being a 60-goal scorer 2 years ago, he doesn't miss too many like that. So he did put it up over Rutherford, and there we go, and a 6-3. Well, it's a big goal for the Flyers. The Wings looked like they were pressing. They had that little bit of a power play before Foligno went off, but that's a big goal. That gives them a 3-goal advantage.
Dennis Polanich picks up the loose puck following the faceoff. There's something rolling around in the corner of the ice. It apparently was thrown on. Barnes picks it up, gives it now to Kelly. Kelly has it taken away. Polanich goes to the corner along with DuPont. Thrown to the far side. Out it comes now to Kenny Linsman. He loses the puck, and Long picks it up for the Red Wings. Board pass to Polanich. Tries to tip it into the Flyer zone. He does. Now it's loose. And Sobchak cannot control, and Kelly brings it up. Feeds a left wing pass now to Linsman. Linsman back to Bjerkegaard, whose shot goes high and comes back to the left corner. Bjerkegaard in the corner. Buck is jammed up there by Long. Buck is still loose now. Sobchak finally takes it out for the Red Wings. Sobchak takes it to the left. Now he gives it to Errol Thompson. Comes out to center ice, gets away from DuPont, goes all the way down to the Flyers' end. Taken there by Barnes. Barnes shoots it out to center ice. Curry Miller goes back to his own end. Miller to Huber. Huber brings it to center, gets it across the left side of Thompson, lets one fly from the blue line. Knocked down by Mir. Left there for Watson. Watson brings it up the right wing. The left side it comes to Barber. Barber's pass intercepted by Vogelbaum. Gives it to Woods. Ball drops it back to Perry. Out of Huber. Pass is headed for Vogelbaum. Went right under his stick and was steered toward Mir, and he was forced to make the stop. Vogelbaum in the corner. Murray Miller's shot deflected. Comes out to center ice now. The Flyers. Doran across to Barber. Barber loses it. And taken by Terry Miller. Out it comes to Woods. Two on two. Woods to the right side. To Bolduc. Bolduc. Shot to the right point by Huber. And it's cleared out to center ice. Huber rams it off the official. Which brings a round of applause from the fan. And it comes back out to center ice. Tipped into the Red Wing end. Rutherford sweeps it back to Huber on the right. Huber ahead to Bolduc. Bolduc has McCourt with him, and it's swept away as he gets into the zone by Bates. Now it's Kropp shooting it out to center ice, taken there by Bergman. Bergman off to LeBrotten. LeBrotten pinned against the board by Daly, was in behind the net, and LeBrotten is being manhandled by the big guy. It comes out to the right point. Larson trying to keep it in. Puck pops free. And it's picked up on the near side by the Flyers' Brian Kropp, and he shoots it back into the wing's end. Now here comes Tommy Bergman. Bergman ahead to McCourt, has it taken away by Leach. A shot is hard off the glass, comes along the near board, Clark, left corner. Bergman trying to dig it out. Gets it to the near side now to Foligno. Back to Bergman. Bergman throws it around the board to the far side, puts it right on Leach's stick. He throws it around the ledge, comes to the left corner. Foligno skates in, has it raked off his stick by Pop. Bergman goes to the corner along with Clark, and they jam it up there. We'll have a face-off to the right of Jimmy Rutherford.
Do you know me? I'm Zena Coker, biathlete. Biathlon combines cross-country skiing and rifle marksmanship. We're shooting with a .22 caliber rifle. It's like make hay slowly, so you're shooting as fast as you can, but you have to be calm. You have to hit the center. I'm Zena Coker. Vancouver 2010 will be my shot.
Get to know your Canadian athletes. Presented by Bell.
Imagine.
Lotto 649's next jackpot is $15 million.
Ryan, what are you doing?
Sir,
Behold, the cheddar bacon Uncle Burger.
Sirloin patty, cheddar cheese, and bacon. Well, it's...
Yes. Yes, it is.
Seriously?
Well, I've never been more serious in my life. Look at me.
The new cheddar bacon Uncle Burger. Seriously, at A&W.
In the war between fun and practicality, there are victims and there are victors. To the victor go the spoils. All new, all that, Mazda 3.
So far in tonight's game. Bridgman and Mahovlich. Huber picks it up in the corner. Throws it to the far side. Hicks can't handle it. He goes down. Huber goes to the corner. Throws it back along the far board. Puts it on Holmgren's stick. He's turned around now by Mahovlich. Now it's Nedimansky. Out it comes along. Long to Nedimansky on the right side. He slips the balls. There's going to be a penalty coming up for tripping. I didn't really see the stick get in there, but there's going to be a tripping call coming up here against the Flyers. As Andre Dupont goes off for two.
He just got the stick between the legs of Nedimansky. Long made a nice pass to Ned, and there's the stick. He just put it in the back of his knee and give him a shove, and a dangerous play. He could have hurt himself going into the corner like that.
The Flyers don't seem to be as physical as they were a couple of years ago, or is that an accurate appraisal?
I think a little bit so. They're going more for speed, and I think they've shown that tonight so far.
Back in the corner, Mahovlich trying to dig it out. Goes deep, picked up there by Thompson. Thompson out to Nedimansky. On the left side, McCourt. Back to Nedimansky. Nedimansky to Thompson. Nedimansky at the right point. Back to Thompson to McCourt. McCourt winds up. His shot is knocked away. It comes out to center ice to Bill Barber. A good job defensively. McCourt and Barber chasing the puck. Barber comes up with it. Now throws it right out in front and is taken by Bridgman. Bridgman with a wrist shot knocked down by Rutherford. And Nedimansky takes it behind his own net. Minute 18 left in the Red Wings power play. Puck gets away from LeBrock. Still in the Flyer zone. Mahovlich trying to keep it in and is jabbed up against the boards by Mahovlich and Leach. And we'll have a face-off.
Flyer checking again. They're just standing up there at that blue line. The Wings, to get by them, are going to have somebody breaking on either wing and get them with that pass like LeBatten did earlier in the first period. That's so defensive. They're standing still there. But the Flyers are standing up, and the Wings aren't going in together. As a result, they're not getting by that blue line.
7:49 left in the hockey game. Leach loses to McCourt. McCourt chased by Leach. Out it comes to Nedimansky. Goes to the boards to pick it up. Out front to Mahovlich. Trying to backhander. Knocked down. Out it comes out to the blue line. Trouble coming up. Here comes Clark. And Clark is chased down by McCourt. Gets the pass off to the left side. But Leach couldn't handle it. And it is thrown to the far wing. Clark picks it up. Out Thompson. Thompson at center. Tried to center to McCourt, who was coming right down the slot, and a semi band on it. We've got a whistle and a faceoff coming up.
This is a good example there, Larry. I think Earl Thompson, a little bit tired after being out there for a minute and a half of that penalty, was looking for help, looking for somebody to come in late and make a pass to, but he didn't get any help. And I think this is why the Wings are not getting very many real good opportunities on the Philadelphia net.
32 seconds left in the Red Wings power play, 7:14 remain in the game. Ogamov in for the faceoff. Goes to the corner, chased by McLeish. McLeish steals the puck. Look out. Here comes McLeish. Rutherford out. He shoots. He scores. McLean. Well, you talk about mistakes. That will have to be one of the glaring mistakes we'll see tonight, Becky.
Well, you just can't let this guy McLeese loose like that. Really, Rutherford's got no chance on a breakaway like that. Rick McLeese, a proven goal scorer. Here's where the play originates, back in the other zone. Larson tried to bring it out the boards to his blind side, and McLeese right there, Reed didn't know it, lifted his stick, went down and fired it on Jimmy's stick side, just inside the goalpost.
That makes it 7-3, and that's a shorthanded goal for the Flyers. Now they have a 4-goal lead here at Olympia Stadium this evening with 7:03 left, and we still have a little debris on the ice tossed down. Now we're about ready to go. That was the third goal of the season for McLeish. They made it 7-3 Philadelphia. This is the first of 20 scheduled telecasts on TV, live from Detroit's Olympia and the Joe Louis Arena of Red Wing Hockey. We hope you'll be able to join us for all of them. Puck taken by Jimmy Watson. He clears it out. Rutherford now leaves it for Larson. Larson starts out the left side. Moves it up to Woods. Woods to Huber. Huber lets it fly from the red line. Hard off the glass. Chased by Bosniak. And it comes out to center, where it's picked up by Holmgren. Holmgren ridden off the puck, picked up by Hogaboo. Woods chasing it on the far side. Larson gets to it first. Now back to Huber. Huber drives it.
But many of those paths have the same starting point.
It's been a while since I needed a tie.
Dad, you're gonna get this job. I know it.
Just for Men. Targets only the gray in 5 easy minutes.
How'd it go, Dad?
Honey, I think I'm gonna need more ties.
Yes!
Just for Men.
To thank you for 50 years, Harvey's introduces the Gift Burger. Buy any burger and on your next visit, get a free original burger. Free? Wow! It feels so good to give.
Harvey's makes your hamburger a beautiful thing.
Larry, you're going to find here with the Red Wings. They've got 5 or 6 new faces. In the lineup, a few others, and it's going to take them a bit of time to get to know each other. Not to make excuses for them, but the big fella Mihajlovic has worked hard tonight and just been hauled down an awful lot by the Flyers.
Bad pass, rake wide, comes all the way back out to center ice. Edomansky has it, shoots it to the far wing. Still at center. Goodbye, Goretz. He's pinned by Larson, and comes back now to Mihajlovic. 3:39 left in the game. Long to Larson. Larson lets it go. Gloved by Mir. Drops it at his side, puts it to the near wing. Goretz picks it up. Goretz out to center. Across the wing blue line, and it looked like Bridgman got in too quickly, and offside is the call against the Flyers.
This is actually the second game, Larry, that these lines have played together. The first four games on the West Coast trip, the first three games, I guess, they had different line combinations, and in Winnipeg the other night, he went to the combinations he's using tonight, so these fellas are still a bit foreign to each other, and hopefully they'll be a little more settled in the future and get to know each other, where they're going to be, and play a little more smoothly together.
Well, it'll take time to put it all together for Bobby Crobb, and he'll be working hard at it. He just hopes it doesn't take too much time. Center ice, McLeish. Up into the Red Wings' right wing corner. Huber picks it up. Up to back now for Thompson. McCourt has it knocked away. Barber with a shot off the glass behind. Foligno throws it out to McCourt. McCourt up to LeBrock. LeBrock tries to get it to Foligno. Knocked off his stick by McLeish. A shot by McCourt knocked away by Beer. Up to the right side. Huber with a bouncing shot. Beer knocks it down. Raked back by Foligno. Goes to the left corner. The court goes in. Now it's knocked out to the center ice. Harold Thompson to Willie Huber with 2:17 left. Huber banks it right off McClitch's skate, and that's sort of the way things have gone here tonight. Thompson gets it out to McCourt. Head to Foligno, tips it ahead, a bouncing puck into the Flyers end, and it's picked up there by Propp. Coming to the left side, McClitch with a shot. Rutherford gloves it, drops it to the left. Long along the far boards. Long picks it up in the corner. Knocked off his stick. Lesman. Lesman centering pass. Heels wide to the right. Barnes picks it up at the right point. Lifts it up into the air. And the whistle sound. The puck was touched above the shoulders by Barry Long with a stick. And we're going to stop the play.
Oh, frustrating night for the Red Wings, Larry. I'm sure that they wanted to come out and win this hockey game, being the first game, opening game at home and for their own fans. And it's got to be really frustrating for them. They're just going to go have to back to the drawing board and get themselves together and come out with their next start and see if they can get it going.
A minute 38 left. Lesman will be taking the faceoff with Hogaboom. Bob. Bouncing puck kept in by DuPont. Prop. Now Bolduc controls for the Red Wings. Bolduc on left wing, leaves it for Woods. Back to Bolduc, tipped in behind the net. Bolduc picks it up on the right side. Avoids a check, loses the puck. Here comes Lindsman with Larson. Turned around. Larson comes up with it. Lobs it to the far side. Now Hogaboom coming in on left wing. Hogaboom shot is knocked down by Beer, and Beer covers it up.
Yeah, some good hustle there by Billy Hogaboom, coming out the wrong wing again off the left side and cutting into the middle and pulling the puck over to get a shot at Beer. Beer went down. Unfortunately, Hoagie couldn't get the puck over, but here he is taking it off the left boards, cutting in, pulling it across in front of the net, but trying to go underneath them, and Bill Muir got down there first. He could have got that up a little bit. I think he had a goal.
67 seconds remain in this hockey game. With the Flyers leading at 7-3. Bridgman will be taking the faceoff with Hogaboom to the right of Muir. More debris has been thrown to the ice, and again we have a delay while it is collected by the linesman. Buck loose on the far board. Woods trying to kick it out. 1 minute. Larson picks it up in his own end. Larson's pass is intercepted by Bates. Bolduc takes it away from Bates. Bulldog's pass is knocked down by Reggie Leach. Leach drops it back in his own end. The bait, and he shoots it up to center ice. Scraped out of the air by Leach. Now Larson back in his own end. 30 seconds left of the game. Out it comes to Woods. It's 3-on-2 of the Bulldog. Bulldog on right wing. Stops, gives it now to Hogaboom. His shot is knocked away. Here's Woods with a hard shot, kicked out by Beer. And it comes to center. Bridgman, the left side. To Holmgren. Holmgren. And a shot sailing high off the stick of Reggie Leach. With 8 seconds left.
Well, right there, could have been another goal. Reggie Leach took the pass in the slot. Tony Bergman, unfortunately, went down and deflected that puck up over the glass. But that could have been goal number three for Reggie Leach tonight.
8 seconds left in the game, 7-3. Flyers lead the Red Wings. Val Bridgman in for the faceoff with the Red Wings' Denis Sopchuk. It's to the right of Jimmy Rutherford. Leach gets it out to Prop at the point. 4 seconds. Prop off to the right side. Return pass intercepted by Huber. And that's the end of the hockey game. The Philadelphia Flyers foil the Detroit Red Wings home opener, scoring a 7-3 victory over the Red Wings tonight.
Rookie Brian Propp and the veteran Reggie Leach, both with a pair of goals to lead the Flyers to a 7-3 win and their third in a row early in that 79-80 season. However, the Flyers were just starting. They either won or tied their next 32 games. In fact, they wouldn't lose until January the 7th when they dropped a 7-1 decision to the Minnesota North Stars. But when it was all said and done, the Flyers had set a professional sports record by going undefeated in 35 straight games. And that mark, well, it still stands today. The Flyers only dropped back-to-back games once that entire season. They finished with a 48-12-20 win-loss-tie record. They made it all the way to the Stanley Cup final, but guess what? Yeah, they were defeated in 6 games by the New York Islanders. As for Detroit, well, they struggled, winning just 26 games, finishing out of the playoffs for a second straight year. In fact, they wouldn't make the playoffs again until 1983. Another classic moment here on ESPN Classic.
Canada Week continues from the 1st to the 3rd. Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders make up an All-American Saturday on the 4th. And we get you ready for golf's most historic event, the British Open, from the 13th to the 15th. All this and so much more in July on ESPN Classic.
You're watching ESPN Classic.